Welcome to my channel. My name is Ibinosa Sarithi Isaac. Welcome to Blended Art Studios. Today we are going to be talking about materials for paint seed drawing. Let us look at the materials we use to make paint seed drawing. This video is going to be quite detailed and quite explanatory. So, the first materials we are going to look at is papers. Your papers are your surface you draw on. So the surface you are going to draw your portrait on. Usually, we use white papers. In some conditions, you may decide to use brown papers or papers that have a shade a little bit different from white. We call them mid-tone paper. Okay, so a mid-tone paper could be brown, could be gray. I've tried some drawings with mid-tone paper and they have their own effect to it. My mind just flashed now to an artist on Instagram that strictly uses only mid-tone papers. So for a long time I was fascinated with his artwork because they don't look like pencil drawings, they don't look like paintings, but they are pencil drawings and they look really unique because he uses brown papers. And how does he do his highlights? His highlights, he uses a white pencil to make his highlights. I've tried that before and it's really an interesting thing to do. I may go back to that for one or two portraits later on as we go on with our videos. So yes, you can use mid-tone papers, but also you can also use white papers, and that's the most dominant one. This is why I believe we use white papers a lot. It's because of the contrast that it provides. When you use a very dark pencil, like a charcoal pencil, on your white paper, it has this attractive contrast that it brings out, and it really pops your drawing more than any kind of paper. Some white papers don't actually look white, some look really milky, but I think the whiter the paper, the better you can draw on. Now, apart from the color of paper, papers also have texture and thickness. And these two things affect your drawings a lot. Now, one thing thickness can cause in your drawing is a very thin paper have the tendency to fold while you shade on it. Because while you are shading on it, you end up applying some pressure to your paper. And a thin paper will begin to bend once your pressure is being applied to it. And another thing it does is if your drawing surface, your drawing table, has some texture, maybe it's a rough table, your shadings will bring out the texture of the table from underneath, and that can be very terrible for your drawings. So in order to avoid that, if you're using a thin paper, maybe a paper even as thin as an A4 paper, make sure your drawing surface is very flat and very smooth. So the thickness of paper matters a lot. I think I use alabaster paper for most of my drawings. Alabaster paper is a very plain, very thick paper. I have found that there are some quality differences depending on who I purchase the paper from. But in general, an original alabaster paper is going to be very thick and very plain on both sides. That's another thing to take note of. Some papers have two textures. They have a plain side and a rough side. Papers that have a rough side and a plain side, you can try it because it's all about experiments. I won't say don't draw on a rough paper, but I'll tell you what to expect when drawing on a rough paper. And when drawing on a rough textured paper, like fine linen or eggshell is another one, like fine linen or eggshell, be aware that the texture of the roughness of paper is going to show in your work. So you are going to be having some noise, I can call it noise, or like white dots showing up in your paper. And to get rid of those, you have to really blend very hard and really shade very hard. And that will increase your drawing time drastically. that will stress you more. But if that's the effect you want to have, you can actually leave the white dots and the texture to show through the paper without forcing it away with blending, and you will have a very unique looking artwork. Okay, so yes, so that's what the textured paper will do to your work. It will, like I said, bring out the texture of paper and show it in your drawing, and if that's the effect you are going for, then fine. But for beginners, because I don't want to struggle so much with trying to blend the texture away, I recommend that you use a plain paper and a very thick paper. So alabaster paper is a very good start for any beginner. Alright, now, are papers important? The answer is yes. The same artist can draw on two different papers and it will look like two different work. So the better the quality of paper, the better your work. You cannot draw on a cardboard or A4 paper and expect it to look as good as an alabaster paper. You will have issues. I've realized that even some really cheap paper like cardboard and A4 I mentioned, if you shade on them, your shades will have, what should I call it now? Your shades will be rough. You will hardly have a very smooth shade on it. It's as though they have, I think it has to do with the finishing of paper. Those papers are mostly for, majorly for printing or for marker. They are usually not for paste drawings. Okay, so it affects your shading if you buy cheap paper. So yes, get an art quality paper like the ones I just mentioned. There are other papers, and if you go online and check on Amazon or wherever you order your materials from, you get really nice paper. And also, for an artist, I recommend you have a lot of papers on ground, because you don't want to be stuck having to always go and buy paper. So just buy them in bulk, they are not so expensive. So that's that for papers. Alright, let's talk about pencils. We've talked about pencils in our previous videos a little, but I want to go into the little bit more technical aspect. And a lot of people don't know this, and it's strange. Well, if you did study fine arts in elementary school, you would have heard that HB pencil is in the middle of the pencil number line. Okay? So yes, there is a pencil number line. We can call it a grayscale, or you can call it a pencil scale. In the middle of the scale, you have your HB pencil. Okay, so middle of the scale, you have your HB pencil. Now, to one side of the scale, you have your B pencil. And further on that side, you have your 2B, your 3B, your 4B, your 5B, your 6, 7, 8, 9, 10B, as the case may be. Now, on that side of the scale, the pencils get darker and softer, okay? So B means blackness. B stands for blackness, H stands for hardness. Now on the other side of the scale, you have your H pencil. Like I said, HB is in the middle. On this side, you have your H. You have your 2H, your 3H, your 4H, your 5H, 6, 7, 8, 9H, 10H, as the case may be. On this side of the scale, as you increase your number, your pencils get harder and lighter. So, color, the darkness of your pencils reduce on this side of the scale. It's clear, right? So it's actually that easy. From practice, you understand that your harder and lighter pencils hardly get exhausted. That is, you can sharpen your 9H pencil and draw with it for a whole month without having to sharpen it again. It's strange, but it's true. But on the other hand, you can sharpen your 9H pencil and in 5 minutes you have to sharpen it again, because they are soft and they get used up pretty fast. So in your whole drawing career, you may end up buying not more than two. In a whole year, you may end up buying just one of these hard pencils, usually the hardest pencil you can find, because you will never really exhaust them. But you can buy more than a dozen of the darkest pencil you can find. Now let me warn you against very dark pencils like 9H. They have this thing they do, especially for graphite pencils. In fact, only for graphite pencils, they reflect light. Now this is something I found really disturbing when I started drawing, is that graphite pencils reflect light. What does that mean? If you hang your portrait once it's done opposite to a window or to a light source, it's going to look like crap. The light is going to be bouncing off it and the dark shades will no longer look dark and it's really going to be ugly. So I recommend you hang your graphite drawings at an angle to your light source, like at maybe, just don't hang it opposite the light source or opposite the window. If not, it will look terrible. So that's one issue I had. So I found out that charcoal pencils actually solve the problem. So once you are beginning to go darker from 4B to 6B and the likes, you are recommended to use charcoal instead of the darker graphite pencils. So use your charcoal pencils. Charcoal pencils also have their grades. You also have soft charcoal pencils, hard charcoal pencils. The harder charcoal pencils are lighter also, but they are still dark. But the beauty is that they don't reflect light. So they are very beautiful. They have their own special kind of blackness. Charcoal black, so that's actually the real black. I was shocked the first time I used a charcoal pencil. I was like, oh, what have I been doing with my life ever since without using a charcoal pencil? I think I didn't use a charcoal pencil for almost a year of drawing. So now I still use them. There's no drawing I do without using a charcoal pencil now because I really like the way they are so black and beautiful.